Good morning, it's Serena, and I was watching while I was looking through my YouTube, and it's started this video of exploring abandoned 1934 murder house, victim buried inside, found grave. So I wanted to stop and I wanted to go ahead and react to it. I love things like this. I'm gonna go ahead and like and subscribe. Let's go ahead and check it out. Thirty-four. That's so cool. I love to see the abandoned houses no matter what. I think those are some really rad videos to watch. Sorry, my allergies are horrible tonight. That is so cool. Oh.
What's up, everybody? Welcome to today's adventure. Today, we find ourselves at an abandoned home. This isn't just any abandoned home. There was a tragedy inside of this home. Sorry, I'm just trying not to slip on all this ice. There's a tragedy inside of this house. There was a murder, and not only was there a murder, the body was buried, hidden, and then found later on. There was a husband and wife that lived here, as I try not to slip. Okay, husband and wife lived here. 2008 financial crisis hit. In 2009, the wife of the husband went hiking. She disappeared, never came back. Husband apparently had no idea where she was. There was a whole search for her, they didn't find anything. Anyway, fast forward to 2009, 1 year later, they did an expansion on this house. The screen doors, that was added in 2009. The body hole, for the woman that lived here, sadly, is still here. So we're gonna be looking at that. Husband, by the way, went to jail in 2010, 20 something years in jail. So honestly, he's coming
20 years, really, really.
Close to his to getting out, so that's pretty scary. Regardless, we're here on site. It's another abandoned house. One person bought this place after, all that drama happened. They tried doing some renovations in here. You might see it inside. But they mysteriously backed out of those renovations. They didn't want anything to do with the house. So now the house sits here, and I believe there's plans for demolition very soon. So we're here at just the right time. I can't wait to show you guys what's inside. And that's pretty much it. If you enjoy, leave a thumbs up. Let's go inside.
I did.
It's a super beautiful house. Built in 1930s. This is the part that was added on. That's where the body was buried underneath the porch. The sun's setting here, so we're gonna try and make this video a little quick. Right away, the front door is great. I love the front
It
door.
is beautiful.
Got these beautiful handles.
I'm very big about architecture. I love it. Love it.
These people had money, so it's very sad for what happened, but Let's go inside.
If you know me, yellow is not my color. Especially like urine yellow.
So, front room, not too much going on. They started ripping the wall.
Look at that glass window. It is beautiful.
Walls out here, but we have a nice window.
Yeah.
Let's close that. This house has a lot of really beautiful woodwork.
Yes.
And right away, we're inside this gorgeous yellow room. And I don't know if you could see it on camera, but the floors are warping from water damage in here. I'll step right on it.
I see that.
It's curved upwards like a ramp.
Oh, look at the molding. Look at that. Look at those little details. Love it, the cherubs. Beautiful.
Got this beautiful fireplace. Still got some prop wood left behind.
Interesting.
And let's not waste any more time. Let's go into the room that everybody wants to see. So this room was added in 2009. And once the police found out about this construction, they were a little skeptical.
Yeah, that's strange.
And that's when they dug up the floor and they found the man's wife just right here. They didn't even cover the hole or nothing. It's just filled with water now. I love this fireplace and the stonework put into it. But yeah, sadly enough, that is where the woman was buried for almost a year. But we're gonna check out the rest of the house. We still have a lot of things to check out here. Quickly, we'll check out the rest of the house, but I do have to comment that they have a huge garden and this place is on the water as well. We're gonna check out the backyard at the very last. They also had a nice in-ground pool here.
The thing I love about architecture, especially with older homes, is that just imagine if this house was in the 30s and it was thriving. It was probably had entertainment with the pool and little parties. I think of things like that. And right now it's dead. It's dormant. You know what I mean?
We have some beautiful carvings over here, all hand carved. This stuff probably dates back pretty far. Definitely no new carvings here.
Probably when it was built.
The kitchen. The pink kitchen. It's actually really nice. I'm a fan of this.
I love those cabinets.
And in the kitchen as well, we have a washer dryer, or a washer and dryer. Pretty random. And we have a pencil sharpener in here also.
Old school, that's what I grew up with.
I don't know if that dates the house anymore. It does a little bit, I guess.
Still
works.
We
even have blueprints left behind. I guess this is left behind from the last purchase of the home. They just kept the plans right here on the table. Pretty wild. Got the staircase. Ooh, I love the carvings on here. The woodwork is amazing. See all the cobwebs on this little banister. But that woodwork is so beautiful.
Yes.
I love all this handmade stuff. And right next to the staircase, we have like the living room. I don't know, that was really weird. I swear to God, I'm not messing around. I actually have the chills going up and down my back right now because of that. I'm hearing a lot of things in here. But I guess back to the exploration.
It's also an older home, could be, you know, you never know, settling of the home and but you never know. But when you have the fact that somebody was murdered and buried, you know, I would be a little freaked out too.
This looks like the living room. Once again, a lot of nice woodwork. I guess this also could have been like a
library study.
A library, perhaps. We have a lot of shelving.
That's what it looks like.
Another fireplace.
I love that fireplace.
It also appears that we have some cable wires coming here, so. There was a TV there.
Right.
So even though we're inside of a empty house, you kind of got to use your imagination as far as guessing what was here at one point. But I'm sure they collected a majority of this stuff for evidence that was left behind. Ooh, we have a really green bathroom.
Oh, wow. Oh, wow. I don't know what to say about that. I like the way they dealt with the sink with the cloth around it underneath, but it's a hard pass with the mint color, but it's still pretty cool to look at. Somebody like green.
This is strange. Very green bathroom. I don't know what era this looks like, but like maybe 1960s or something.
Yeah, that's what I got.
Kind of like the color, but in this house it's creepy.
Yeah.
Oh, we have another staircase that goes even higher up.
Wow.
Oh, we have a lot of bedrooms to check out. Looks like we got the master bathroom.
I like that.
Pretty nice. We still have a toothbrush left behind. Just still hanging up there. I'm sure that has some DNA on it.
I was thinking that.
Also have a huge like jacuzzi tub. That's pretty nice. Got wallpaper on the ceilings.
Oh my.
Wallpaper.
My husband loathes wallpaper. I'm gonna tell him about it. They just wrap that bitch everywhere.
Roll around. Okay, so this looks like the master bedroom.
Wow.
Oh, this actually has a bathroom already inside of it, so what we saw wasn't the master bathroom. This one looks a little weak, though, compared to the other one.
Right.
Got a sliding glass door. Ooh, this is a weird sink. This looks like a dresser, and they just propped a sink on top of it.
I think that's kind of cool.
That does not look right. It really is just like a dresser that they made a sink. That's really odd. So anyway, I'm led to believe that this is probably the master bedroom. We got more closet space here. Can't even move it. We got some shoes left behind. And then women's shoes too. The name of the shoes are called Wanted too. If you could see that.
What a coincidence.
You can see the view they had.
That is beautiful out there.
They have their own little indoor pool, or in-ground pool, I should say, right there. And off in the distance, this house is directly on the water, and it even has its own dock. Beautiful home, multi-million dollar home, based on location here. And we're gonna check out the rest of the house, then we're gonna hop back there and look at their expansive garden they had on this property. So we got a couple view rooms over here. Let's go into the open room. Oh, we have a pink ceiling. That's cool. Looks like there was a bed here. Small bed. Child's bed. Oh, and we have a pencil sharpener here. Another one. Boston self-feeder. So online, I didn't read that the family had kids, but it appears that way. This looks like it was a child's room, perhaps a girl. Got a pink bathroom.
Oh, that is cool.
Sounds pretty nice. Like the big window there. Ooh, the shower head is in such a weird spot. I've never seen a shower head like that. Let me know if anyone else has. That's so weird.
That is really strange, yeah.
To me. Right in the center of the wall. Looks like it should be right over there in the center.
Right.
Anyway. Got all your basics. Just a pink room. With some bad wallpaper. Okay, the sun's getting darker and darker on the horizon, so we gotta finish up this house. And it's on to the attic. Let's see what's up here. They got a steam vaporizer here. Looks pretty old. Looks like a 90s technology. I'm not quite sure. Maybe I can find a date on this. I don't know. I don't see anything, but it's still right here. It honestly looks brand new. I really love the shelving in here that they built into the house. You know, this dates back as far as when the house was constructed, so it's woodwork I can really appreciate. Nothing in these drawers, and they're hard to open because they probably haven't been in so long. But there's nothing really left in this house anymore. Still a really cool house. A lot of weird feelings involved with it.
Yeah. I love when a house is like the rooms that have different angles. I love it. Sorry, that's my clock.
That's nice. I like that design in the house.
Yeah, me too.
Is it a door or a window? It's a window. Pretty nice. I like how it opens up this much. Get a lot of fresh air in here. So that's gonna really be it for the inside of the house as far as exploration goes. It's a small house, it's a cute little house. One that has a really dark history, but I couldn't resist coming here, filming, taking pictures because of everything that's happened. I didn't really have any expectations as far as what it looked like in here, only an exterior shot. And right now we're gonna head into the backyard. See what else is here. Back at the base of the stairs. It's going through the kitchen one more time. I like this kitchen.
I love the house as far as the bones of it, how the rooms are, the way of the placement. There's lots of room, but there's no way, never, never, never would I live at that house. Never, never.
You even have like a little, what is that? Are those gingerbread houses up there?
No.
They started doing some construction or renovation in this room first. You have that nice little light fixture, but they started with the ceilings, you got the insulation all coming out, and the floors are a little gone. And, you know, there's not much left in this house, but it's the story that brings us here. And for one last time, we're going to pay our respects to where the woman, unfortunately, you know, was buried. So for one last time, moment of silence, I guess. Rest in peace. All right. Now, outside's a little different from the inside. Everything's dead out here. This family had a lot of plants and wild, you know, flowers. All of it dead now. Pool is covered and filled with ice. Got a little fountain over here.
Ooh, I love fountains.
Looks like a lot of gardening stuff was out here. All dead. Like, you could see one day, all these plants are here inside these pots. The plants are still there. Just one day somebody upped and gone, and nobody took care of these things ever again. It's honestly really sad.
I love it. Oh, sorry. Let me go right back just a few, like a still away. And
it's honestly really sad.
The arbor. I love arbors. My at my grandparents' house, both of them have passed, but my mom still lives there. And there is one there, and it's overgrown and all that, and it's pretty rad. I love the small details like that.
This property goes back and back. Like, it's almost like they have like a whole public park in their backyard. It's got more stonework here, beautifully done.
Yes.
It's a beautiful property. I just can't believe it's not being taken advantage of, and I believe it's going to be demolished very soon.
I mean, really, like, would anybody really want to live there? I would not. I don't even know how you could even deal to do that to begin with. And then to bury in your house and knowing that that her body was there. And that's just so... It's creepy. It's creepy, and I feel sorry that happened to her.
And this was the final little area. It's really overgrown, though. You can see they had a little gazebo there.
Nice.
It's very overgrown now. All these thorns and plants were not here at one point. But that's what happens of years.
What is that?
Of it neglect is. And
oh, that's beautiful.
Just nobody around. I'm trying to make my way through here. I'm keep getting tripped up. I'm just trying to see what else they have. Living right on the water. The beautiful sunset.
That is beautiful.
All right, everybody, that's gonna do it for today's exploration, for today's adventure. Definitely a video unlike others that I've done. Most places I go to, they're abandoned because of death, perhaps, but maybe in a more natural way. This is a first for me, going to a location that is home to a murder, home to a murderer, and here I am, here we are. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this walkthrough of this dark, dark property. If you did enjoy, leave a thumbs up. It lets me know right away. And right now we're on the road to 500K, and that's super exciting. I can't wait to hit that goal of mine.
Wow, there you go.
Have a good day. Stay curious, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace out.
Okay, well, that was interesting. I love it. Like, I watch stuff like that all the time. If it's something that you're interested in, then I'll make some more of the videos of it. He did a very good job with that. Sound like it's just him. So I don't know if I'd be able to do all that. So that's pretty impressive. Congratulations with your 500K. That is awesome. Okay, well, I hope you enjoy the video. Have a blessed day. Bye, y'all.